All right, Gary's, what's going on? Welcome back to the Keeper Eat YouTube channel. We're down here at Sydney Motorsport Park for day two of the high-tech oils drift all-stars, round five
in the Barrel Lagoon.
Jason is out on track doing media stuff. We're about to kick off. If you haven't seen yesterday's video, go check it out. We did practice and qualifying, pretty average conditions in the wet. It was pretty miserable. Think tonight's gonna be a bit better. It's gonna be dry. Jason got third position qualifier, which is all right. Not bad. He's in the hunt for the championship, just behind Brody Mayer there in the white S13. So there's like 35 point difference. Slight chance that he'll win the championship. Fingers crossed. Hit the like button for moral support. We got JB Rogers.
That's it.
Hi, JB Rogers.
Again.
He's
gonna take the win.
Yeah, yeah,
got the beers ready to go.
Got the bevies.
Scotty behind the camera's gonna get a few beers, aren't you, Scotty?
If you enjoy all this cutting quality, it's all thanks to Scott Mitchell Media behind the camera. Oh yeah, check him out on the socials. And shooting bulk flames. Got this GoPro here.
How's it go?
Stay tuned, Gary's, let's do it!
Hey, so I had a chat interview for TV. A little bit average. We got to talk about the car, you know, first time in high tech this year. You know, we just built this car mid-year or whatever it was. I only got into the second round with it. Then we started dominating. We got a third place, I think the second comp. No, first time in the wagon.
They didn't know what hit them.
They didn't know what hit them.
Third place straight away, then we moved up to a second the next round, and then a first in the last round at Queensland. So we just got to back it up with another first. Let's get this dialed. Dry track, that's what we want. We got Glennie Boy. He qualified just under us, I think, so it'll be really good to drive with. We didn't get too many good runs with anyone yesterday, so this will be the time to shine. Play with those gears, see if we can get third, a bit of high pressure. Let's do it.
Thing to do, you just didn't enter hard enough in the lead. You have to do it, you have to do it. You've got to enter properly.
Give us a little rundown on your one lap.
We sent it, and then, yeah, that was a bit of a waste. Now I've got like a 3-year long line to get back out. That's a bit disappointing. Nice fun trying to get, you know, play with lines and stuff, and And yeah, rammed him on an entry because he was a bit slow and held up a bit, so.
You get that.
It's also a little bit slippery out there, that from all the rain and whatnot and dirt that's been thrown around. So on the sort of outside line, it's very slippery.
I wouldn't change anything about what you did. Yeah. The entry was really good, aggressive. You need to be aggressive, you have to be.
Yeah, and over the ripples, felt pretty good. Yep. Apparently that's a big point.
The inside corner, when you were in the dirt, when you spun, the back wheels were in the dirt.
Yeah.
Once all these cars go, that'll clear up.
Anything else, don't know.
You just got to be super aggressive. The judges will love it. Yeah. That's where you win it.
Aggressive, mate. Aggressive.
Aggressive. So the cracked alternator issue is getting a bit hot there. It was smoking, so.
Bang!
Thanks to Danny Probert, he got a spare here. One thing that's on our list for the NZ spares, but hopefully the same plug and whatnot.
She's fresh. Yes, yeah, it looks good, I think they're all the same, but.
FG's not, FG's electronic. Yeah. Bolts and it pulls out the second bolt.
It's a 5mm.
Imagine if that was my nose. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's it.
It's been hit too hard.
I was looking over the car, the Savo, and the alternator was cracked, and like the bolts that hold the alternator together, one of them came out, so I tightened it back up. The cracked alternator, it was still charging and working fine. So I told Jason like 10 times, let's get a spare alternator, but he doesn't like buying spare parts. And next thing you know,
goes out for one session, 3 laps, comes in, gets back in the queue, and the alternator was basically smoking, probably about to catch on fire. And Jesse was gonna muck around with it. I started the car and it was really low on voltage, so it was kaput. Lucky Danny Probert over here had another alternator. He's given it to us, so we just smacked it in quick. His little batch.
Literally smacked it in.
It fell on his head as well. He didn't realise it was all the bolts were out and landed on his face. So like he didn't break his nose, but I reckon 10 minutes, 15 minutes maybe?
Yeah.
Had to
pull the bottom batch plate off to get the alternator out. So that's a pain in the ass.
Hopefully we're all good. Did a little bit of damage to one of the pulleys up the top of the motor. It's a plastic pulley, so it should right itself. The belt should just teach it a lesson. So hopefully we're all good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
very slippery out there. Got a few not as hectic battles first up, trying to get our line dialed and sit ourselves where we want on the chase. We've got a bit of a break now, so park her up, have a HSP, we'll jump back in for some battles. Oh, cool. I'm on TV.
That's you.
That's me.
Oh, Gary!
Ah,
oh,
true.
Game time, boys. So we got Ben Meir ready to go. It's been a while since we've been out there, so let's get it done. JB Rold was in my ear. Wish us luck, boys, all the way to the top. Brody won his first battle. A little bit sketchy, he's very gripped up, so it's interesting. Let's get it.
No one's got nothing for the barrel wags, look.
Yeah, let's just like do a fucking
out for the show.
Yeah,
pull out battle.
Do like a photo comedy. Nah, that'd be pretty tough.
Keep it going, huh?
Yeah. All the way out there. Top.
Thank you.
Hug.
Oh, big hug.
You just need to, when you get your car straight, just try and get it in there, and get it in and on the angle and
that's your angle, you know what I mean?
Yes.
Probably, like, maybe that was a little bit too safe thinking.
Yeah.
Just be careful with the safeness, that's all.
Yep. Top 16 all done with Mr. Ben Meir. We did play a little bit safe, probably too safe, and we've gripped up the car too, and the track's also gripped up, so there was all that into play. But we threw it in and it gripped up a bit shorter into the entry. Same thing the next lap around, because it's 1.5 laps. So we knew we had to go hard, so we threw it right on him and he just sort of went deeper until he went off. Apparently he bent a tie rod like on the entry, maybe on the ripple strip, don't know. We're through to the top eight. We need to get it sorted, get our lead sorted next run, because we've got, I think they might be battling it out. It's either Flash Smith or Jamie Rold. Who have we got? We got Flash. All right, so we got Flash. And he's going really well. He's driving amateur, so he's got bulk, practice, and track time in. And he's a local. Yeah, he's a local. So, but his car was very slow, and we followed him in the wet. So I'm tipping his car isn't going to be the quickest, but he'll be online, and he'll do his best to stay with me. So we'll see what happens. But we'll be sending it, but I've just got to get that line right. Get that line dial, and then we can take it to the battle if we get through that, which will most likely be Mr. Matt Harvey. Which would be a hard one. Let's do it.
Shhh. Mate, well done.
Top four, baby. Matt Harvey. So Matt Harvey's up there in points too, so a bit hard on the foot brake with those last couple of battles. I reckon Harvey will be a bit faster. So make sure you stick with him. As soon as you get cut off, you're cut off, so you've got to make sure I just stick him there, send it. Yeah, if we've got to push him around the track a little bit, so be it. Don't tell his crew. Hopefully he just sees this later in the vlog and it doesn't happen. But we'll see. I'm not going to promise anything. It's carrying one piece when it goes to D1NZ. Let's do it. Let's send it. Ready to go.
Number one championship leaders.
He's gone out for his top 8 battle. He's broke something in his first run. So he's got a 0 for his first run. And he's got to try fix it and go out for his second run. So this would be the championship over for Brody. Could be a big upset in the championship standings.
You don't wish it on anyone, of course.
No,
but it sucks. But it's the scenario that Jason would need.
It sucks. Nothing worse. The tension is high in the pits. The tensions are high.
That's down a cylinder.
Yeah.
Control, like what the hell? It's alright, Matt's got the job done.
Then rerun.
Solid battle, goddamn. Definitely young heart.
Belts.
Oh, look, we're going to get a win here. Who is it going to be between these two? Matt Harvey gets the win. We'll battle it out. We'll 1-2 on the podium. I mean, Brody Marr will secure the championship, and Jason Ferrin will secure second place. Look at this. Yeah, Matt Marr into the big tunnel. Any emotion? Brody Marr up to out. Oh, these guys, I know they do a lot of island drift together as well. They do some judging together. It's a small community down there, but to come over here and all the work they do, and the disappointment of Brody Marr going at the mechanical issues there in the top eight as well. I mean, what an emotional moment down there, Damien. Jason Ferrin!
Try not to drop it. Make it hook.
Yeah, your boys.
Why don't it break? Where is he?
You got me more. Do you want me to do that?
Oh, God damn. Break a trophy, can't do anything. Oh, my eyes. Jeez, alright, we're here. We finished. The night is now over. And we did it.
Third place for the night.
Yes.
Second place in the championship. We got dog nut.
I feel like this is the place I needed to be. Brody, he very much deserves, like, the amount of effort that those guys go to just make it. Like, they've got to make a trip on the boat from Tassie every time and try and cut all that shit. So,
building his own car and his shed and everything like
that's
that.
That's it. Yeah, self-built car. Unlucky he blew a motor. So hats off to him. I'm very happy in this second spot.
It's been a big year.
We also just built a car.
Yeah. We also
Jassy came in late in the season.
There was also a lot of points left on the table. Round one was a 33 with a DB in the top 16.
Yeah.
And then we
built a wagon in between round one and round three.
It's not even building a wagon. It's like developing a car all season. Like bit by bit after every round, change something.
And what is known to be not a very competitive car.
There's no weight reduction going on there.
The amount of times I've stood up the top near the judges and people are like, I can't believe that thing's so fast.
But how's he making a wagon do that?
Corey was at a few rounds, I think. Round one.
Corey slogged some hours on this thing.
Yeah, Corey's having done some hours.
Pulling the gearbox out on his ass.
The main one is probably the sandblasting of the undercarriage. Probably the worst possible job.
In his big white suit. Great.
Nah, the whole crew. I mean, there's a bit of the whole crew in this car, 100%. I started driving in 31s, and now we're here. Like, you know, one season in our first proper built, you know, pro level car, and we've got this far. Definitely didn't expect it. I thought it would be, you know, somewhat competitive with the parts we're using, but, you know, to be that fast and this competitive, absolutely stoked. It's amazing. So hats off to the crew.
I feel like we need all our names then here.
Tom Sharp. All names.
Tom Reed.
Bernie.
New Zealand's not going to know what hit them.
Yeah, 100%.
Next year.
D1NZ, you know. Sad to see this car leave Australia, but she'll be back. And we've all seen... We've all seen the V3's coming. So I'll quickly just touch on the sponsors that we've got for the support of this car and hopefully carry on to next year, D1NZ. We've got Zoo Performance, Shockworks, the coilovers, Acostal, the Kang Lock steering, the Stewie stuff. Obviously, the big boy, keep it reet. Support, like, subscribe if you enjoy this. Hyper Gear Turbos, that turbo's still going strong. Mackie Elec with a lot of fittings, parts, and knowledge on the Barras. Phoenix, Ben Jenkins, Troy Jenkins over there, supporting the radiators, coolers, all the stuff, and all the stuff they do for giveaways. BST, best bloke ever, tuning the car, spending the time on all the refleet, everything. Pulse Titanium on the spicy titanium exhaust we keep breaking with anti-lag. But that sound, though, and Mini's patent panel for, of course, giving us the spicy paint jobs that he does. And to finish off, the crew, Jassy building the car, JB Rolders in my ear, all the media guys, this time we got Scott Mitchell, shout out, shoot! Got the daddy seal of approval. But of course, Tom Shepard, everyone at the shop, and Danny and the fam. And that's it. I'm sure there's more, so I'll comment them down below. But yeah, make sure you like, subscribe.
D1NZ, son.
See you on D1NZ.
Get it, boy! Thank you.
non-stop. We going non-stop. Yeah, we won't stop. Say you're looking.